So today's video is all about two of the most common elements which we as designers tend to use in most of our landscaping projects, whether it's a residential terrace or a farmhouse or even commercial establishments. These two structures are always used in some or the other form when designing landscape or any outdoor space. But बहुत से लोगों को इन दोनों elements में क्या difference होता है, इसमें काफी confusion रहती है. So in this video, I will try to address all your queries related to differences between an element such as a pergola compared to a gazebo and which one is right for you. You're watching Design and Living with Chirag, and if you're looking to install one of these structures in your outdoor space, then I suggest you must watch this video till the end. Starting with the most basic question, what is a pergola? A pergola is an outdoor garden feature forming a shaded walkway, passageway, or sitting area of vertical posts or pillars that usually support cross beams and a sturdy open lattice upon which woody vines are trained. Coming to what is a gazebo? On the other hand, a gazebo is a freestanding open garden structure, sometimes hexagonal or octagonal in shape, with a roof. Many a times, gazebos have built-in sitting inside the sheltered area. Also, to add a sense of enclosure and privacy, outdoor curtains or drapes are also used. वैसे तो ये दोनों ही definitions Wikipedia पर भी मिल जाएगी. But in this video, we will try to understand something more than the textual definition of two of the most commonly but still extremely important elements in any landscape design project. Let us start by understanding the main difference in their design characters. See, as we all know, इन दोनों के structure में एक से ज़्यादा elements होते हैं, starting with usually raised deck floor to pillars or post to horizontal beam supporting the roof, and lastly, of course, the roof. But the element which creates the most difference is the roof. The design of the roof greatly differs between the two. A gazebo may have different types of roofs, sometimes in the form of a dome or maybe pyramidal, or in modern times even curvilinear, and हम कोई अपना different style of roof भी evolve कर सकते हैं. But when it's about a pergola, the roof is usually made using horizontal planks, which we call rafters. I'm not saying that there is no innovation possible in design of a pergola, as roof is just one element of the entire structure. But yes, if we talk about roofs in particular, a pergola's identifying factor is its roof. Wherein a gazebo provides full coverage from the sun, a pergola allows for sunlight to shine through its slated roof. Typically, a pergola provides partial shelter and shade over a garden pathway or a patio. The crisscrossed wooden roof is an optimal space for plants and vines to climb. Meanwhile, gazebo roofs are many a times designed from the bottom too, leaving it opaque, unlike a pergola. Also, with innovations in technology, there are some great ways the roof of the pergola can be designed. From motorized soft cloth covers to rain-sensing metal louvers, technology is really making things interesting and useful for all of us. Definitely, all these luxury elements come for a cost, but they do solve some purpose as well. I believe by now you all know what a pergola and a gazebo is and what differentiates them from one another. The fourth and the last point for today's video will make you understand the purpose these structures solve and what factors you should consider before choosing the two. किसी भी element को जब हम अपनी space में add करते हैं, चाहे वो indoor area हो या outdoor हो, उनके mostly दो ही purpose होते हैं. First and foremost, that it should have a good aesthetic appeal. This absolutely is a factor which cannot be compromised. And secondly, it should be functional and solve our purpose. If I consider these two factors while choosing between a pergola and a gazebo, then the decision is not that difficult. On your screen are factors for decision making. The first point is area and size consideration. See, if your space is small, then a gazebo might make the space look smaller due to the amount of area volume wise and vision wise it covers compared to a pergola, which visually may look much lighter, covering almost the same amount of roof area. But if the purpose is to create a dedicated sitting or dining space and make that particular part of your garden a focal point, then any day, a gazebo adds a lot of charm and solidity to your outdoor space. Pergolas are usually not a focal point, but something which merges with other elements. A nicely designed gazebo is something which the eye cannot miss. On the other hand, if you're looking at some form of extension from your already built up covered space, then don't think of going for a gazebo, as gazebos look best when they stand independently and are a focal point of the garden, as I said earlier too. Wherein a pergola looks great when attached with an existing structure and is the best option if you're looking for extending your indoors to the outdoors or just creating a deck. Now coming to the third point, which is a very important point, which is cost comparison. Though the cost of such designer structures depend on a lot of factors such as size, how big the structure is, how big the structure you plan to incorporate in your garden, to the type of material you select for its construction, and finally any value additions you plan to incorporate in that structure, like the ones you see on your screen right now. But if I generally compare a pergola and a gazebo of similar size as far as covered area is concerned and using decent finishes, probability of a pergola costing lesser than a gazebo shall always be more due to the extra cladding elements which are inevitable when making a gazebo. A typical cost for a pergola may start from somewhere around say 800 to 1000 rupees a square feet, whereas a gazebo's cost may be double than this. But as I said, it is all very, very subjective and depends on the design totally. Also, if cost and space are less of the constraints, my tip here would be to integrate both the structures as part of your landscape and create some great designs. Having said that, if you haven't watched my previous videos on top ideas to create an exclusive terrace garden, you may watch it now. There are some great tips to consider. And if you have any questions, you can ask in the comment section below or connect on my Instagram. Link will be in the description. I'll be happy to answer them all. Also, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, you may consider doing that as well. Thanks for watching, everybody. Bye-bye.